Often we want to dissect or understand a particular trait. Forward and reverse genetics is the path or the sum of approaches that are used to dissect or understand the effect of phenotype and genotype on each other. Forward genetics is about identification of genetic factors or genes which is responsible for a given trait of interest. Or you may say that we go from phenotype to genotype. On the other hand, in reverse genetics, we manipulate genetic factor or genes to see its effect on particular trait. That is, we go from genotype to phenotype. Let's take an example to understand this better. Suppose you want to study disease resistance in a particular plant. Now you can see the disease phenotype from a resistant plant. So you know the phenotype, but you do not know what are the genes or the factors which are responsible for this resistance. Therefore, you have to choose a suitable forward genetics approach, which I will be explaining in a moment. Consider another example. You have a gene whose sequence information is available. Here, you do not know what is the function of that gene and what is the effect of that gene on the phenotype. That is, we are going from genotype to phenotype. Here, we do not know whether the gene controls the yield, resistance, color, or any other trait. For this, you use a suitable reverse genetics approach. Now, what are the approaches that are used in forward and reverse genetics? In forward genetics, these are the approaches that can be used. First is the mutational breeding. In this, you induce random mutation and generate a mapping population. Next, genetic mapping is done to establish gene-phenotype linkage. Linkage and association mapping. In this, you determine the genes associated with trait based on their linkage after several crosses. Map-based cloning. In this, first you have a genetic map and you want to determine a marker that is tightly linked to the target gene affecting the phenotype. This is done by sequencing. This way, you identify gene linked to the phenotype. Insertional mutagenesis using tDNA insertion or transposon tagging. In this, a known sequence tag is randomly incorporated in the genome to see its effect on the phenotype. In all these approaches, your aim is identification of genes responsible for a particular phenotypic trait. Compared to reverse genetics, these approaches are more laborious and time-consuming. Now talking about the approaches used in reverse genetics. 21 to 25 short oligonucleotide sequences are used, which silences the expression of its target gene. Antisense RNA. It targets the mRNA and is used to block the translation. Gene overexpression. In this, the gene is attached to a strong promoter and transformed in the host. Site-directed mutagenesis using TILing, or targeting induced local lesion in genome. Gene knockout or genome editing is done using CRISPR-Cas, ZFN and TALEN. Transcriptome analysis, here you compare the transcriptional level between two samples. In all these approaches, you mainly target a specific gene and alter its function or check its expression to determine its phenotypic effect. These approaches become more convenient if whole genome sequence information is available. The major challenge here is the genetic transformation protocol. Success rate of genetic transformation is extremely low in case of non-model plants. Sometimes researchers use a combination of two approaches to confirm their study. So here is a quick summary of what we have learned today. In forward genetics, we go from phenotype to genotype using approaches like genetic mapping, insertional mutagenesis, map-based cloning, and this is based on random mutations. In reverse genetics, we go from genotype to phenotype using approaches like RNAi, CRISPR-Cas, TILing, etc. The aim of both the approaches is to dissect the trait of interest and to study the relation between genes and phenotype.